Thank you, Anish, and welcome to the Peterson Event Center, where St. John's looks for its first ever win, 0-5 in this arena. Last year, these two teams met. St. John's with a win over a ranked Pitt opponent. St. John's was looking for a win over a ranked team. They finally got one on Saturday. Flashback to Madison Square Garden. Big night for Mo Harkless and the Johnnies, especially on the defensive end of things. They held Notre Dame to less than 40% shooting. Harkless was a superstar, and he's really been the main scorer for St. John's this year. And the Johnnies survive a final scare from Notre Dame, which had a very poor shooting night. St. John's, in 11 tries, finally gets his first win over a ranked team this year. With Bob Valvano, Adam Amin on hand, and two teams that are trying to get ahead of steam going into the Big East tournament. Really impressive for St. John's, considering they're 5-4 with an all-freshman lineup.
Yeah, that's the big thing, is they're winning with freshmen. To put them out there and get their confidence shattered does no good, but they've gotten better and better. You talked about Harkless. D'Angelo Harrison's been terrific as well. Their defense and rebounding, though, in this winning streak has really picked up. For Pitt, even though they've struggled, I had the Louisville game with them over the weekend. It's business as usual. They're right. Preparing, they're playing hard, they're defending. They're a lot closer to being a very good team than one that's down in the bottom third of the standings. So they're going to be back on the rails sooner rather than later.
Let's take a look at our one-on-one tonight and two players that try to anchor these teams in the offensive end.
Well, Mo Harkless, I think, is a key tonight because he is their leading rebounder, almost 9 a game. And this is a terrific rebounding team in Pitt. That is the one thing they do as well as anybody in the country. He's going to have to get to the glass. For Pitt, they rebound. They've had trouble scoring, and this is a guy who's got to get that done for him. Jamie Dixon wants him to shoot the ball. He was passing up shots against Louisville. He's got to get back to his strength on the perimeter, catch and shoot, knock down some perimeter jumpers, and get on the board.
And another freshman five starting lineup. The fresh five, as they're calling them, 5-4 with this starting lineup of Green, Harrison, Harkless, Pointer, and Amir Garrett.
Let's not overlook Harrison with all the celebration about Harkless. He's only a 17-point-a-game scorer, 37% three-point shooter, and makes 81% of his free throws, scoring at a premium in this conference this year.
Meanwhile, for the Pitt Panthers, final home games for Ashton Gibbs and Nasir Robinson. Dante Taylor was relegated to bench duty for a stretch, went back into the starting lineup against Louisville, had a very good game.
Yeah, again, one of the keys to the good job they did at Louisville, gave them a great interior presence, 11 points, 5 rebounds, 2 blocks, had a strong game on the inside for the Panthers.
Mike Dunlap filling in once again for Steve Lavin, who continues to recover from successful prostate cancer surgery back in October. You see the white Air Force Ones that the coaching staff has continued to wear since their win over Duke last year. In honor of cancer awareness, coaches versus cancer, they were wearing the blue bow ties on Saturday at Madison Square Garden in recognition of prostate cancer awareness. Jamie Dixon, certainly his toughest year in his 9 years as Pittsburgh head coaches. 10 straight years that Pitt has been to the NCAA tournament. That streak obviously on the line unless Pitt wins the Big East tournament. But if Connecticut proved anything last year, anything could happen once 16 teams all converge on New York City. Tim Higgins, Michael Stevens, Evan Burrows are veteran officiating crew.
I'll tell you one thing real quick. I don't know if I've ever had a game with where the two teams combined for just 10 wins in conference, 10-22, and yet the two coaches have done such a good job. They really have. I mean, under very trying circumstances, these guys have done a terrific job all year long with these two teams.
Harkless and Taylor for the chip, and the Johnnies will start it off. They've won 3 straight, coming off their first win over a ranked team against Notre Dame. They can top out as a 9 seed come Big East tournament time. They have never won at Peterson Event Center, 0-5 in 5 trips to this building.
This is the portion of the attack where they make the game shorter so they don't have to worry about foul trouble. Those first 5 passes were designed to do nothing but run clock.
Shot clock down to 8. Green has been shooting with a lot more confidence this last month or so. He knocks it down to start the night.
Doing everything with more confidence. That was just a stroke. Walk in the park. Look at Pitskies. They've got to keep St. John's off the line. Johnny's outscore you by 5 from the free throw line. And then Pitt can't negate their rebounding edge by turning the ball over. St. John's does force turnovers. You see them put pressure on right there. Active hands.
Taylor nearly lost it. It came into the hands of Nasir Robinson, the senior. He and Ashton Gibbs, 99 career wins, playing their final home game. The keys for the Johnnies tonight.
Absolutely. That's exactly how they beat Notre Dame, by the way. held their own on the backboard, and they limit four threes for the Irish, and they made three. They don't make a lot of threes. It's a recipe for success again tonight.
So Dominic Poynter, tough shot, and there is Nasir Robinson for the rebound. Pitt on a five-game losing streak, coming off a tough loss to Louisville. Here's Ashton Gibbs.
That's absolutely Jamie Dixon applauding from the bench, because that is what he has to do. Catch and shoots what he does.
Harrison trying to answer. Two very good three-point shooters. Gibbs traditionally, and Harrison has been lighting it up from outside at 38%, second in the conference with now his 70th three.
Well, maybe they heard my points. You know, hold your own in threes. You make one, we'll make one.
Dante Taylor. Taylor's added more punch since going back into the starting lineup. He's been relegated in and out between the starting five and the bench. What a finish by Mo Harkless. You're going to see a lot of that.
So much for the slowdown. Let's run some clock.
Wow. Good offensive start on both sides. Seven apiece, not even 3 minutes in. Robinson, Garrett, and Poynter both closed in on him, and a turnover.
And there's those active hands we talked about. Johnny's got almost eight steals a game.
Pitt, 14th out of 16 teams in the Big East in turnover margin. As good as they are in the glass, sometimes they negate it.
Right on cue.
Whistle and a foul called. They're going to see Gibbs try to shoot a little more tonight, and Harkless finish around the rim.
Well, he has to do this. You know, I think he's been concerned with trying to show people he can do things that they said he doesn't do well. That's what he does well. Plenty of strength. That's a strength for that guy. Harkless with the explosive move on the baseline. Leading scorer, a second leading scorer on the team, leader in blocks and steals. Look at those last couple of games. He's going to be the weak. What a great future for actually both these teams. St. John's with that five freshmen starting lineup, but Jamie Dixon has put together a great recruiting class as well.
One of his good young players is in, and J.J. Moores. Harkless going to the rim will go to the line. Talib Zana in as well. There's Moore, who in the last three games has been a dynamo off the bench, 16 points per game. He's led the team in scoring the last two times out, 21 against South Florida, 16 against Louisville, and Harkless had a great game against Notre Dame the other day, 22-9.
Well, to Moore, to the point about Moore, not only is he scoring, what efficiency, 65% field goal shooting in those last three games. And, boy, I'll tell you, I've done more games this year, Adam, I'll just be candid, where they've been 52-48, 49-45. Points have been at a premium. And this game looked like it might have the makings of that again, but not so, as both these teams are scoring at a good clip. Harkless both 2 for 2 from the line.
Four early for Harkless. Johnny pressure. Gibbs just a couple seconds to get it over the timeline and does.
St. John's, I had them against Louisville. You did. You had that game also.
Right.
And they really struggled. They look like a different team right now. Their confidence level is completely at a totally different level. That man deserves a lot of credit for it, by the way. What a job he's done.
And this team was struggling a little bit before this three-game win streak, St. John's. Then Steve Lavin made an appearance at practice before their game against UCLA last week and really lit a spark under this team and got things back on track. Moore can't connect. Green the rebound. And this is where the Johnnies will push the tempo.
They are very good collectively off the bounce.
Green's 2 for 2. And from outside, just 24%, but he's been so much better the last month.
That's what I say. They look, their confidence level is, and you know, winning will do that to you.
Understandably so. Trey Woodall, who's had a roller coaster season dealing with injuries, trying to work past an abdominal tear and a groin strain. Thought for a while he was back healthy, saw that four-game win streak, and things kind of turned around again. He's never been 100% healthy.
They've had every conceivable kind of challenge this year. Boy, what a great start for him today.
Gibbs with the two. Harrison misses the three. Moore squares the rebound.
So, see, those are the kinds of turnovers. That's just careless. Very lucky they didn't turn that over there.
Gibbs wants another. Got another.
Yes, welcome back, Ashton. We missed you. Where you been, son? This is the Ashton Gibbs the conference fell in love with, or if you're a fan of the other team you lived in fear of. Catch it, find the rim, shoot it, accept congratulations. That's been his recipe for success, and what a great start tonight.
Ashton Gibbs with a great start. Already a couple of threes, 8 points for Ashton.
But again, one of the things they talk, I think they're going to look at this, see if it's a three or a two. That's what the officials are doing. Doesn't matter. He's in a rhythm, catching and shooting. Jamie Dixon reminded him of that. You know, it's amazing, and all guys get caught up in this. If somebody tells you you got a weakness, you want to prove it, you play away from your strengths. I think he's been doing a little bit of that this year.
Officials taking a look whether that was a three or a two, so we'll step aside.
Up to when I go to bed, I'm working and focusing on the business.
We went from my mom's kitchen to an 8,000 square foot facility.
My name is Sharon Waddy, and I'm the owner of Spa La La.
Why do millions of business owners count on Vistaprint?
We went to another printing company. Nothing was right.
Their hours are not 24 hours a day.
And finally, my friend was like, you need to try Vistaprint.
At Vistaprint.com, you can make anything from business cards to banners to brochures.
They make it really simple to be able to create your own product the way you want it to look.
At Vistaprint.com, it's easy and affordable to look professional.
That's how we actually got some of our first customers, was by using these postcards.
And my sister was like, this card is amazing. You actually look like a professional company now.
Go to Vistaprint.com and get 250 business cards for only $10. 250 cards, $10. Vistaprint.com.
Everything else we've had a problem with. Vistaprint not.
The Big East Women's Quarterfinals, Sunday on ESPNU.
ESPNU's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Toyota. As you get a look at the Fort Pitt Bridge, downtown Steel City, and we are tied at a dozen apiece. They went back and looked at that last Ashton Gibbs shot. It was ruled as a three. The flashback to last year, Jamie Dixon, fourth-ranked Pitt, Steve Lavin, and the St. John's Red Storm at Madison Square Garden, Ashton Gibbs. We saw a lot more of this last year, a career-high 26 points, but Dwight Hardy, the underhand flip to give St. John's a one-point lead with 1.2 seconds to go. And Pittsburgh unable to get the prayer to fall, and St. John's, one of its six wins over a ranked opponent a year ago. They finally got a win over a ranked team in 11 tries this year on Saturday against Notre Dame. Phil Green. Well, it's Gibbs against Green right now. Green's got seven of St. John's 14.
And you made the point right at the top about how much more confident Green looks. He did on that play as well.
Gibbs off to a good start as well. He's got 8 points, an offensive rebound for the Panthers. Here is the suddenly quick scoring J.J. Moore with the assist off to Dante Taylor.
This game has some serious offensive rhythm, much to my surprise. Well, that can't be good. Mo Harkless is hobbling and is going out of the game. That has got everybody involved in the St. John's program holding their breath, I'm sure. Wow. We'll keep an eye on that for you.
Well, he'll get tended to. You see, kind of pointed at his right foot, maybe the ankle. And Dodds give to Chua, checks in. St. John's has been through a lot this year. They run a six-man rotation, essentially, with five freshmen and Achua, who's in his first year out of junior college. Malik Stith was the only returning letter winner from last year's team. He left the program after 23 games. He'll still remain close to it, but not in a playing capacity anymore. So a tight rotation for St. John's with 10 to shoot here. It's Achua.
Always tough to come right off the bench. First time you touch it, try and make a move. I always believe you should catch it, pass it, get a little feel for it. You want to be aggressive, but Amazing how many times that first shot won't go when you just come cold off the pine.
There's Cameron Wright off the bench. And the third Pittsburgh turnover of the night. Phil Green all the way home.
Oh,
missed the layup.
My.
Oh, boy, that. You just, as a coach, you can't stand to see that. Again, both Gibbs misses off the dribble, always makes off the pass.
Wright knocks down the three off another offensive rebound. Seven to one rebounding edge for Pittsburgh in the early going tonight. There's Garrett. He got it knocked away by Cameron Wright. Still a dozen to shoot. And here is the freshman Mo Harkless. We saw him limp off, and he's actually a moment ago just went back to the tunnel. You see nursing the ankle a little bit. That's a big loss right now for St. John's.
Oh, another mistake. Well, now they start looking like freshmen a little bit. Green missed that breakaway layup on the inbounds pass. Get in bounds. Let's stand out there and become a spectator. They tried to throw it back to him, and he had yet established position on the floor. Those are easily preventable mistakes that should be easily avoided.
Gibbs 3 of 5 shooting to start the night as Pointer out on him. Doubled Garrett and Harrison in that zone. Still 8 on the shot clock. Gibbs passes up another one. Gives it to Moore instead. The tip dunk from Taylor. 6 for Taylor, and Pitt leads by 5.
Just what he did at Louisville. Very active.
St. John's basketball.
Guys rotating to the penetrator. Ooh, that might have been close interference, didn't it?
Very close to still being on the cylinder. They'll credit it to Taylor. 3 early field goals for Dante Taylor. Good game against Louisville when he was back into the starting lineup. And a good start today for him as well. Trey Woodall's back in, so they go a little bit smaller. Zana, Wright, Woodall, Robinson, and Moore. You see things getting a little chippy already between these two teams. A lot of young guys, and Bob already mentioned it, that these are going to be two teams that have a lot coming back next year.
Good officiating. Preventive medicine is always the best.
Tim Higgins, Evan Burrows, and Michael Stevens are officiating crew. Splitting the double. Zana tipped it. Wright comes out with it. Largest lead in the early going for either team, and that's 4 Pitt turnovers now. Green leaving it off for Pointer. 4th Johnny to score in this ball game. St. John's back within 3.
Well, that's just a bugaboo they've had. And it's been all year, and especially against the St. John's team that will turn you over. As we said, they average just under 8 steals a game.
Something Jamie Dixon talked about a week ago was the lack of patience at times for his offense. They at least look a little more patient today. And J.J. Moore will go to the free throw line. That'll take us to a timeout. Moore will have a couple of shots coming back. Good start for Ashton Gibbs tonight.
Gibbs is much more aggressive offensively. This is the Ashton Gibbs we've grown to know in this league. And he is dead on tonight in that perimeter game.
Before you tackle your projects, stock up on Craftsman Innovations at the Tool Mega Sale this week, only at Sears. Get up to 50% off all Craftsman Mechanics tool sets and Craftsman tool storage. Plus, hundreds of other Craftsman tools are on sale. Craftsman, trust in your hands.
They say a guy should try to get out of his comfort zone every now and then. But at Wrangler, we just don't see it that way. That's why Wrangler 5-Star Premium Denim jeans are made with a U-shaped construction. They don't cut into you like jeans with a V pattern, so you're always right in the zone. Room where you need it. Comfort where it counts. Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
Emily's just starting out and on a budget, like a ramen noodle every night budget. She thought Allstate car insurance was out of her reach until she heard about the value plan. Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you like Allstate.
In Pittsburgh tonight, and the Panthers up by three in their final home game of the 2012 season. St. John's and Pittsburgh back and forth in the early part of this ball game tonight. Some news and notes around the Big East. Syracuse, the win over Connecticut this weekend. Big East regular season championship. UConn struggling. They lost to Providence the other night. And Notre Dame has lost two games in a row as well after having a nine-game win streak. Lost to St. John's on Saturday, and then last night, or rather on Monday night, I should say, to Georgetown.
I really think it underscores two things. And makes that Syracuse record even more impressive. How small the margin for error is in this league, isn't it? I mean, we've seen teams go from 2 weeks looking like they were on a roll to then 2 weeks later looking like they may not win another game. This St. John's team labored mightily. Now they won three in a row. Louisville had a terrible two-week spell. They bounced right back. UConn now struggling again. This Pitt team has been kind of up and down in terms of streaks. It's very, very small margin for error, which is one of the reasons why Syracuse's dominance is all the more incredible. And it really is. It's just, it's leaps off the page at you, given how close everybody else is in this league.
I think another thing we've learned this year is how tough it is to win on the road in the Big East specifically. Only Syracuse has a really solid road record. Everyone else is either a little around 500, barely over it, or way below. J.J. Moore, a couple of free throws to get into the books. Five different Panthers and four different Red Storm have scored in the early part of this ballgame. Harrison from the Achua screen, the kick to Pointer. And a foul will be called on Cameron Wright. Oh, championship week is upon us, and the Big South Conference Championship, the semifinals, coming your way tomorrow night on ESPNU. Already a couple of upsets in the conference tournament. BMI over Coastal Carolina, Winthrop beating Campbell. The championship coming your way on Saturday noon on ESPN2. Screen roll against the zone. Pointer to Achua underneath, and God's give to Achua, who came in for Mo Harkless, who went limping off a couple of minutes ago. He scores on a good feed from Pointer. Harkless is back on the bench and is on his way to the scorer's table.
Well, that's, you hear a collective yippee go up from Queens in New York. I'll tell you what, that was shaky a few moments when he hobbled off.
Robinson with the floater got it to roll home. This year, Robinson, third leading scorer on Pitt, has four.
He's another guy who's played banged up all year with that knee. He has to get it drained after every practice. They've had a myriad of problems to overcome.
Had surgery before the season to correct an injured meniscus, and he's still tonight making his 64th consecutive start at power forward. Harrison lost it. Zana picked it up, and here comes Woodall. They've got the numbers pinned. Moore. And how about Achua? All by his lonesome, able to knock it out of bounds. And Harkless, still with a slight limp, will come back into the ballgame for Achua. It was tied at 14 when he left the ballgame. Right now, Pitt leads by five.
That was one of those style over substance breaks. A little concerned about throwing the lob and looking pretty. You're three on one, you got to get a shot off, and a good shot at that.
Gibbs has had a good shooting start tonight. Off the mark there. He's missed his last couple of attempts. Harkless was out of bounds when he touched.
That's all right. They'll take that shot 100 times out of 100. Gibbs with a catch and shoot in rhythm. They love that, and why wouldn't you? That is his bread and butter.
3 for 6 from the floor. The three-point numbers are down, but Bob mentioned it before, too. He's been trying to do a lot more this year than just be a shooter.
Well, he had to, and they moved him to the point on top of it with the Woodall injury, and he's never gotten back to really playing to his strengths. He did early here tonight. One more. That's the one. Fire away.
Gibbs, 3. In and out. Tap back out. That will end up with Woodall. That's been the big Pitt advantage early tonight on the rebounding end of things. The senior is trying to connect, and a little too tall for Nasir Robinson.
Well, the storylines we put out there at the very beginning have been on the money. Pitt's turnovers negating their rebounding edge. Boy, you talk about a streaky season, huh? Look at that.
11-1 start to the year. They lost to Wagner here at home back in December, and that kicked off an 8-game losing streak. Trey Woodall missed a good chunk of that. Came back against Louisville. They went off on a 4-game win streak. Seemed like they were back on track, but Woodall has been banged up. Robinson's been banged up. Now they've lost their last five, including this past weekend to Louisville at the Yum Center.
Well, look at that. I mean, that guy is coaching his brains out. He coached his heart out at St. John, at Louisville. His team played their heart out. And that's why his program's had the level of success they've had as long as they've had. Vince Lombardi used to say, winning's not a sometimes thing, it's an all-the-time thing. And even when you're having a down year, your values have to be consistent, and they are. This team is prepared, they defend, they're playing hard.
Well, teams with solid shooting starts in the early going, as you can tell by the score in less than 12 minutes. The team's over 45% from the floor. See how Harkless moves. Remember, he left the ball game for a few minutes, limping off the floor. Still 9 of the shot clock for St. John's.
Senior class, by the way, looking for their 100th win tonight. We're winning a senior classes in school history. That point about long-term excellence.
Gibson Robinson, 3 to shoot. I don't think Garrett realized that Harrison has to jack one up. And Garrett gets the offensive rebound, and Jamie Dixon could not be more upset.
Good presence of mind by Harrison, who took one out there by the center circle, but kept possession for his team.
Here's Harrison. That one more in his range.
Yeah. It's a little bit more normal. Beautiful catch and release. He's the leader on this team in all the three-point categories. Attempts, makes, percentage, 37%. In fact, really the only consistent three-point threat they've had.
Green lost it. Green to Garrett, and he gets fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line. 7:33 to go here in this first half. Pittsburgh's led by as many as 5. It's a 2-point game here in Pittsburgh.
My name is Bernard James. I play basketball for Florida State University. I mean, my military service really fully lets me enjoy and appreciate that I'm able to play basketball right now. I still have friends that are in the military serving overseas, you know, putting their life in danger every day. So I do realize how blessed I am right now to be here safe playing basketball.
This is the computer ICU. It's what happens to your computer when it gets infected. Slows down. Crashes. And if you don't do something, your computer could wind up here in the computer graveyard. But it could be saved with mycleanpc.com.
Is your computer running slow? Are you frustrated with error messages, blue screens, computer freezes, and crashes? Then go to mycleanpc.com for your free diagnosis today. Then just activate the mycleanpc.com software to fix it in minutes. And computer specialists are available while you're online.
The best thing about mycleanpc.com was it had a free diagnosis.
My computer is 100% faster.
You know immediately what the problem is, and the problem is solved right then and there.
Download your free diagnosis today at mycleanpc.com.
Anais Shroff in studio. Cincinnati entered the night with an RPI of 76. No school has ever gotten into the NCAA tournament with an RPI that high, but a chance for a marquee win against Marquette tonight. And the Bearcats up by 8 in the early going. South Florida, meanwhile, one of Joe Lunardi's last 4 in. They're up 1 on Louisville.
That could be the one, Anish, for South Florida to try to cement themselves into the tournament mix. 10 teams right now out of the Big East in for Joe Lunardi. Last check with South Florida in there. Seton Hall, a loss to Rutgers this past weekend. That kind of hurt their chances a little bit. They have a game against DePaul, who's locked into the 16 seed coming up this weekend before Big East tournament time rolls around.
My 30-second soapbox here for the knuckleheads. Don't count in college basketball. Doesn't count. College football lovers. And I like college football too, but it's so preposterous when you look at two things: A, the teams that are quote in playing for their seeding, because as you know, most years the four teams that make the Final Four, the total of their seeds comes to less than 10. So you want to get yourself a seed in the top four. Arguably the top two. And then look at all these teams in this conference that are still playing to get in. There's some really good teams in that bunch. Cincinnati's got work to do. South Florida's got work to do. Seton Hall, UConn, there's some really good brand name teams have lots of work to do. They've got work to do to take care of the basketball.
That's right.
Panthers, my goodness.
7 Pitt turnovers now.
That's the story of why the Johnnies are still in this thing. Look at the rebounding margin. Pitt has negated it by not being able to take care of the basketball.
It's 3 straight possessions for Pitt with a turnover now. Their lead trimmed down to 1. Did get word that Harkless just came down a little wrong on his ankle. That was around the 15-minute mark. He's been back in the last couple minutes. He does seem to be okay. So does Harrison. And now D'Angelo Harrison, the all-time freshman scoring leader in St. John's history. He surpasses Eric Barkley for the freshman record as a Johnny.
That's appropriate that he's done, has shown the versatility. 2 threes and then that beautiful body control drive right there.
Patterson taking a 3 and knocking it down. Third of the conference in 3-point efficiency, and everybody getting involved on both sides. 6 guys apiece on both teams have scored.
Well, when Pitt's been able to take care of the ball, they've gotten good production and the kind of shots they want. As you said, a 40% 3-point shooter. Patterson in a catch and release.
Green against Woodall. 2 point guards going at it. There is Patterson for the rebound. Gibbs at space, got closed out by Garrett. Patterson again.
Good rebound. There's that presence that we thought St. John's needs to get by Harkless.
Green will draw a foul on the floor. Back in 1998-99 season, Eric Barkley eventually became first-round pick of Portland. Scored 500 points as a freshman. And D'Angelo Harrison, 502 on the year. And now the all-time freshman leader in scoring. Meanwhile, for Pitt, Trey Woodall picks up his 2nd foul. Green was trying to throw it off of John Johnson, who just checked in. Numbers for Pitt. That's how you run the break.
That's what I was going to say. That's a better 3-on-1. Right off the blackboard. Nice pass, good easy finish for Johnson.
7 different Panthers have scored. They're back up by 4. Both teams have led by as many as 5. Harrison will draw another foul. Well, we saw this earlier, a 3-on-1 that failed miserably, this time a little smoother.
Here's the first one. Look at the good spacing. The one defender can't guard all 3. And then a nice job of Patterson to avoid the charge after the pass. Stopped by the foul line, not right at it, but high enough so that the defender could possibly cover him and the receiver of the pass and give Johnson an easy one. Good, simple, fundamental basketball.
Zana picks up his 2nd foul. Nasir Robinson will get a breather as J.J. Moore comes back in. Taylor came in for Zana and Jamie Dixon's team. It'll be the bonus the rest of the way for St. John's. Garrett with the left hand missed it off the rim, and Last touch by the Panthers. Amir Garrett, who's really been more confident. We say that about a lot of these guys, but it's certainly the case. And remember, we're talking about freshmen. Garrett, since being put into the starting lineup, averaging nearly double figures. This is his 12th start of the year.
And you know, it's a very, oh, there's a turnover by Harrison. Well defended by Gibbs. You know, you're making them have to play with a lot of decisions to make also, because they have to be able to manage the clock, get a feel when to go, when not to go. They have to be aggressive in the defense, but they can't get in foul trouble. It's a lot of pressure on freshmen, along with the normal transition that goes from being a high school player to a college player.
Fresh five freshmen for St. John's, starting for the first time against West Virginia back in January. First time that five freshmen started for St. John's since the Wonder 5 days in the late 20s, as Taylor gets another good feed and finishes hard at the rim. It's the largest Pitt lead at 6. Shot clock down to 9. Tim Harrison goes himself. Harrison got it to go. And into double figures.
A versatile game. A couple of threes and then a nice drive earlier. A little body control. That one, a tough little floater. That's an awkward distance. Made it look easy. Nice flash by Gibbs.
Off the heel. He's missed 4 straight shots after a hot start. Comes St. John's. Harrison, a 3. Got it down. D'Angelo Harrison with 13 for St. John's, and a timeout called.
This the term, I try not to over go to the well when it comes to some of the wisdom that I think my brother Jim was able to give me in his many years coaching, but this is one of the, watch this, they want to take a look at this if it's a 2 or 3, but this is, my brother Jim used to refer to as the anatomy of the game. No game, 2 games have the exact same shape. And what separates good teams from poor teams are the teams that understand how to adjust based on how the game's going. Harrison has a good feel for the anatomy of the game. That was a perfect time to go, be a little aggressive, take a quick shot, and turns it into his a bucket, whether it's a 3 or 2, still a very impressive offensive performance of the Johnnies are within 1.
It's Champ Week, and Notre Dame highlights the Big East tourney on ESPNU Sunday. At noon and 2, the quarterfinals tip with spots in the semis on the line.
Backdoor cut by Skylar Diggins.
The Big East women's quarterfinals, Sunday on ESPNU. ESPNU is home for the passionate college basketball fan as our experts break down the top 25 in a weekly special.
2 teams again.
Our panel has every aspect of the game covered. The Experts, Tuesdays at 1 on ESPNU.
When's the MRI? She's got something better.
See anything, Doc?
I see everything.
We'll put in a backup. We don't have a backup!
You don't need one.
As a VA pharmacist, I have technology like computerized patient records that helps me make a difference in the care of our veterans. And that's what they deserve.
Learn more about careers with today's VA at vacareers.va.gov.
In East Schroff in studio, we remind you at halftime we will take you live to Shout Florida and Louisville. The Bulls, one of Joe Lunardi's last 4 in. If they beat Louisville, it would be Shout Florida's best win of the season.
Seeing 338 in each. D'Angelo Harrison with 13 points to lead all scorers in the early part of this game. A good offensive game so far. Good offensive half for both teams. 1-point lead for Pitt.
Panthers shooting 60% from the field. Rick Storm at 50%. been very efficient offensively, with one exception, that is the Panthers' propensity to turn the basketball over. Seven turnovers so far.
Five ties, five lead changes in the early part as well. The Gibbs, along with Patterson, Johnson, Moore, and Taylor, who's 4-of-4 from the floor. Garrett will guard Gibbs. Work back into the zone. We've seen that for the most part from both teams tonight. Patterson the pitch. That's Johnson for three. Offensive rebound, and Lamar Patterson's got 5 points. Pitt's back up by three with just over 3 minutes to go in the first.
Exploiting that rebounding edge. And their strengths, the Panthers. Good answer that was.
Gods get the chew with 4 points. Everybody getting involved on both sides here in the first half offensively. Trey Woodall off the floor for Pitt, their point guard. He's got two personal fouls. He's one of the two guys in this game who's played but hasn't scored. Johnson will draw the foul. A championship week on the ESPN networks. The Ohio Valley Conference. Murray State's been the story all year. Will they get beat? Getting a bye into the semifinals. Tennessee Tech, potential opponents. Morehead State, Tennessee State, could see them in the championship against Murray State. Traditionally a one-bid league, the Ohio Valley. Could we see a bid thief come out of the Valley? Oh,
every Power Six conference in the country has got their Murray State banners and T-shirts. They want to make sure only one come out of there.
Johnson knocks down a couple of free throws off the Achua foul. Back to a three-point lead for Pitt. Phil Green fading, firing, and getting it to go.
Really, Phil? Feeling hard, your son. That was a tough shot going left and jumping basically straight back for his ninth point of the game he's having.
Four field goals already for Green. Here's Johnson. Passes up a three.
I like how aggressive Pitt's been. St. John's knows they can't foul, so they've been taking advantage of finding creases in the zone and attacking. This has been a better defensive possession for St. John's.
Forcing a tough Johnson three. Tip to Garrett. And J.J. Moore the steal. And Achua commits the foul.
What a heady play by Moore. He had sized that up right from jump street. Garrett really looked careless with the ball. He paid for it.
But Phil Green, who in the last month, he's shooting better, he's scoring more, and that's been big for St. John's.
Well, they don't, you know, they have a weird stat dynamic. Their assist to turnover ratio looks awful. You'd think, my gosh, they must turn the ball over awfully, but they don't. They just don't get, a lot of assists because they do so much off the dribble.
Another turnover for the Panthers. Here's Harrison for three. A whistle and a foul. This will go against St. John's. Garrett and Gibbs battling down low. Well, Pittsburgh, 8 turnovers here in the first half.
Well, that's what's kept it close. And some of these are really foolish decisions. You can't dribble between three guys, let alone two there. And it leads to an easy bucket at the other end for St. John's. That's some careless passing. Good idea. Bad execution behind Robinson. And then this one, maybe Sean Bradley. Not many other guys call that one in. It's a reference for you. And another perfect example of a careless pass.
But Harrison got it stolen underneath. Who's going to have it? It'll be Pitt basketball.
Well, nice job. That's one thing. That's why I say the mindset. That's what I look for in this Pitt team in a struggling year. That was a nice job by Patterson. Off a mistake. You don't see anybody. They don't have any quit in them. They just keep making the next play. Come back, strip it, get the ball right back. That's been the trademark of a Jamie Dixon team.
Did you not think I would know the Sean Bradley reference?
Well, you're only like 12, aren't you?
Here's Moore inside, and he'll head to the free throw line. Friday, 11 Eastern, ESPNU presenting a special edition of College Game Day covered by State Farm. North Carolina and Duke, for the first time, a Game Day special the night before, devoted to the greatest rivalry in college basketball. Friday night at 11 Eastern before Saturday night in prime time, two of the top six teams in the nation squaring off. North Carolina and Duke from Cameron Indoor Stadium. They had quite the fiasco the first time they met in Chapel Hill.
Yeah, look at those delicious standings setting up for a very dramatic last weekend of the regular season and ACC tournament. I'm going to give a humble brag here. I'm going to be doing every single game in the ACC tournament on ESPN Radio.
Are you okay?
Single game. I'm not talking
about
11 games.
You got your power bars and everything? You ready to go?
I'm ready, dude. I can't wait.
Harrison lost it on the way up.
Pitt making that turnover discrepancy get narrow here by being very active on their defensive end, creating some steals.
It's now 7 St. John's turnovers, so minus 2 for Pitt. About a 5.5 second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Shot clock down to 9. Johnson did not travel there. It'll be an open 3 for Patterson. Got it!
Boy, that was nice execution by Pitt there. Nice composure, good spacing, and you put it in the hands of a guy who knows what to do with it there.
It's the 5th Pittsburgh 3 and the 2nd for Lamar Patterson.
This is not reviewed, is it? He's 3 feet behind the line. What are we doing now? They call timeout? There we go. Look at this. That is deep range. St. John's tends to, especially in the first half, play a little bit soft because they're so afraid of foul trouble, but that's just too much room for a 40% three-point shooter.
See the 5 three-pointers for Pitt. St. John's averages just 4, and they're off to a good start shooting. St. John's near the bottom of NCAA basketball in three-point shooting, but shooting well from outside. The balance on both of these sides. This is a really, really good first half offensively of basketball for both teams.
A little bit surprising, to be honest, because you and I have both seen them struggle a bit. The Pitt game at Louisville, both teams, every possession was like birthing a baby. I mean, it was
laborious.
It was laborious. Good choice of words.
Well, 8.2 left, and St. John's is trailed by as many as 6. Down by 5 here. And they'll have a chance for the final shot, and they'll put it into the hot hand of Harrison. Harrison with 3 to go. Try to dump it off for Green, and Pittsburgh with a defensive stand to end the first 20 minutes. Now Harrison did have 13 points to lead all scorers in the first half. Now the all-time leading freshman scorer in St. John's history, but Pitt had 3 different guys with 8 points apiece. Good balance from the Panthers, who have a 5-point halftime lead, 38-33. Now we go back to the studios with Adrian Branch. Here is Anish Roth.
All right, thank you very much, Adam. 5-point game at the half. Peterson Events Center, a tough place to play, but we were just talking off the air. You're impressed with St. John's poise, given the fact they do start 5 freshmen.
I'm not impressed with them. I'm very impressed. Folks, I am very impressed with the Fresh 5. 5 freshman starters for St. John's, the first time since 1928 when they were called the Wonder 5. And look at them on the road. They're shooting over 50%. And this is a place, Pittsburgh, even though they've been down, even though they hadn't been to Pittsburgh of the last 10 years, they've only lost their home record is 30-37. So they win almost all the time up to this last year. But it's all about St. John's and the young pups. They've got something. They're on a keg of dynamite for next year.
All right, Johnny's looking for their 4th straight win. Pittsburgh trying to snap a 5-game losing streak. Meanwhile,
back on Wednesday night hoops from Pittsburgh, PA. 2 teams that have been playing at relatively slow offensive paces, trying to find their offensive stroke. All of a sudden, they have number 1 combined for 71 points and 55% from the floor. Who would have thought? With Bob Valvano, Adam Amin on hand, pretty good offense on both sides for 2 teams that were looking for it.
Yeah, it was an easy game on the eyes. It had a nice flow, and we had a lot of offensive versatility inside, outside. I realize St. John's trying to avoid foul trouble, and Pitt has had stretches where they've given up points, but still, credit the offense tonight. They've been good.
Yeah, on both sides, a lot of balance. Just about everybody who played in that first half got in the action. Phil Green playing with much more confidence offensively.
Yeah, look at the different ways they scored. Green on the outside with the 3, then the leading scorer for the
to Johnny's D'Angelo Harris. He was a nice floater, and Pitt, not to be outdone, goes to their perimeter guy. Ashton Gibbs, he got off to a great start, made his first three shots. And then the good ball movement, the nice drive by Patterson with the dish and the flush by Taylor. Taylor had a big first half, four field goals. So a little inside, outside, lots of versatility. Easy game to watch.
Combined 17 turnovers, but a faster pace and good offense on both sides.
Picky.
Yeah, it's I had to find something wrong with that.
No, that's legit. That was a big problem for the Panthers, especially turning the ball, no question.
Well, Trey Woodall was off the floor for a good portion of the first half with two fouls. He was one of the two guys who played and did not score in the first half, but he did have three assists.
Panthers have to be pleased with that. So much time on the bench for him, and they're still up five at the half.
Woodall to Robinson, and one. Let's hear Robinson with 6 points. We take a look at our first half stats. St. John's not great from the outside for the season, but right at their average, 4 threes and a good percentage.
Well, the margin was small, and the rebounding margin was bigger than that at one point, but they were making up for it by the turnover differential. But you see Pitt close that gap, and that's when they managed to take the lead, continuing the rebounding edge. Not turning the ball over as much.
Pointer picked up the foul, and now it's the largest lead of the night for Pitt at 8 points.
More with us earlier. Harkless twisted his ankle a little bit and was left the game for a short while, but as you see, he's out starting the second half. He's moving a bit gingerly for a while, but doesn't look like it's too severe.
Comes out for the screen for Green. Six in the shot clock. Green against Woodall. The freshman with a tough shot. Phil Green is 5 of 7 from the floor, and he's got double figures for the ninth time in the last 12 games.
That's why they don't get a large number of assists. They run the shot clock way down, and somebody's got to create. And more, that's been Green now.
Here's Woodall looking for his first points of the night.
Pittsburgh doing a nice job of exploiting that kind of soft zone. They look like they're attacking, and they'll try and get steals on the perimeter, but if you get inside it, you can score, zone or man, because they don't want to foul you.
Coming down the final stretch of the Big East season, two teams looking for a head of steam going into the tournament. A turnover. Here's Woodall. Back to Patterson. He gets fouled and scores.
Well, Green amplified his mistake. He turned it over and magnified it by fouling and making it a possible three-point play. And the Panthers on a roll.
And they've got a double-digit lead for the first time tonight. Ninth turnover for St. John's. Taylor to Woodall for another assist, and Patterson finishing at the rim.
The ACC and SEC Women's Semifinals Saturday on ESPNU.
Wake up to when I go to bed, I'm working and focusing on the business.
We went from my mom's kitchen to an 8,000 square foot facility.
My name is Sharon Waddy, and I'm the owner of Spa La La.
Why do millions of business owners count on Vistaprint?
We went to another printing company. Nothing was right.
Their hours are not 24 hours a day.
And finally, my friend was like, you need to try Vistaprint.
At Vistaprint.com, you can make anything from business cards to banners to brochures.
They make it really simple to be able to create your own product the way you want it to look.
At Vistaprint.com, it's easy and affordable to look professional.
That's how we actually got some of our first customers, was by using these postcards.
And my sister was like, this card is amazing. You actually look like a professional company now.
Go to Vistaprint.com and get 250 business cards for only $10. 250 cards, $10. Vistaprint.com.
Everything else we've had a problem with. Vistaprint not.
I'm proud to be a healthcare professional with VA. With our advanced technology and the care we provide, our work truly fulfills America's promise to our veterans.
Learn more about careers with today's VA at vacareers.va.gov.
7-2 start to the second half for Pittsburgh, with its first double-digit lead of the night, nearly 2 minutes in to the second half. Let's take a look at how Jamie Dixon built this Pitt program. It is brought to you by Craftsman. Certainly a tough year for Jamie Dixon, but the success has been there for a decade.
Well, look at all the numbers. The Big East titles, two in the regular season, one in the conference tournament, five Sweet 16s. How about the six straight 25-win seasons? Then this stat, this is a marquee conference. From 2001 till now, they have the best winning percentage both overall and in Big East games. Now, that's not to scale, by the way. That's
right.
Not Jamie's real head. But there's the Elite Eight run in 09. And just a, and you want to know really the truth, and I remember this. When he took over for Ben Howland, they had a decidedly soft schedule at the beginning and won a bunch of games. And it took a while for people to appreciate, longer than it should have, what a wonderful job he had done in that transition. And now the body of work speaks for itself. He's just done a masterful job.
Garrett stepping back. Taylor with a rebound. Big night for Dante Taylor, former McDonald's All-American.
Chubb's going to have to do their thing defensively and get some steals to get some easy ones. They're not going to be able to dominate the backboards.
There's Woodall. Nothing in the first half. He's 2 of 2 and half number 2.
They're really hitting a rhythm right now, the Panthers. They're not turning the ball over, playing with great confidence.
11 to 2 run for Pitt to start the second half. Nearly another turnover. Garrett right into Dante Taylor. Most people think that Jamie Dixon's going to have this team back on track, and it's hard not to believe that. A colleague of ours, Tim Welsh, said that every coach has his turn in the barrel. It happened to be Jamie's and Jay Wright's this year, but a lot of positive for Pitt coming in next year. Seven-footer in Steven Adams and a great point guard out of D.C.
Well,
James Robinson.
You know, not only that, we always think so much about the potential, and you saw the ESPN rank 13th, but look at how many nice young players he's got on the floor right here that are going to come back. I mean, it's not like the cupboard's bare. So you add a nice recruiting class to a group here that's still in there punching. That's the thing I said I loved right from the start. They played their hearts out at Louisville. Those are the games that are the better yardstick for me. When a team goes on the road in a quote-unquote down year, what are they doing? And they were working hard and digging and rebounding and defending. That, to me, was a good yardstick of the commitment.
Four of four to start the second half. Pitt from the floor. There's a steal for Garrett. He's got Harrison ahead of him. Instead, he'll take it all the way in. Again, foul on Lamar Patterson.
The game was close when St. John's had a decided edge in turnovers. When Pitt narrowed that down, they got that separation. So the Johnnies getting some turnovers, but doesn't do you any good unless you convert them, and Garrett misses an opportunity there.
Split a pair a moment ago. Mike Dunlap been in for the majority of the season for Steve Lavin, who's recovering well from successful prostate cancer surgery, still doing the cross-country recruiting trip, still going to practice, still working with the team often. Came to practice before the UCLA game last week. Seemed to inspire the guys a little bit. They went off on a three-game win streak. Still very much a presence. Even though a lot of people in New York seem to think he's not, he very much is.
And they both, and that's a fine line. He's made a presence felt, but he doesn't want Mike Dunlap to feel like, hey, I'm looking over your shoulder. Everything you do, I'm second guessing.
Dante Taylor into double figures. Back to a 14-point lead, and Patterson, those two guys have done that a lot this year. Good big-to-big passing for Pitt.
Well, we saw that in the first half, almost a carbon copy of this. Take a look at the flash high, draws the defender, quick bounce pass. That's the thing, not only the quickness of the pass, but the right type of pass. The instinct is to catch that, throw it in the air, and it's probably going to be deflected. Beautiful bounce pass. This is the second time Taylor's flushed one off of a bounce pass from Patterson.
Taylor, 5 of 5 from the floor, 11 points, 5 rebounds. And you see Curtis Aiken, one of the McDonald's All-Americans, the first ever All-American at Pitt. Curtis Aiken, Dante Taylor, one of the first All-Americans to come to Pitt in nearly 20 years. So that was a huge pickup for Jamie Dixon, another guy who's going to be back next year. Foul on the floor is called. I was watching ESPN Classic today. St. John's and Pitt were squaring up from 1984. Aiken was a big part of that tonight. Some of the younger guys for Pitt have been a factor. Trey Woodall has been banged up all season long. He's got five quick ones here in the second.
When do you take five-hour energy?
When I'm on the night shift.
When they have more energy than I do.
When I don't feel like working out.
When there isn't enough of me to go around.
When I have school and work.
Every morning, it's faster and easier than coffee.
Every afternoon, when that 2:30 feeling hits.
Every day.
Every day.
Every day is a five-hour energy day.
Five-hour energy, every day.
This one's called the Kansas City Shuffle.
That's so Kansas City.
This one's a little trickier.
Okay.
It's called the Japanese Night Baseball.
Love it.
Whoa!
This is the hardest one ever. The Apollo 11.
Oh, no way. Sunroof?
Yeah.
Hello!
You
wasteful showbo.
Well, you just ate something that was on the roof.
I've eaten stuff from under the car before.
100% white meat and irresistibly poppable. Jumbo popcorn chicken. This is how you Sonic.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Downtown Steel City, 15-point lead for the home team. Pittsburgh, 4-plus minutes into the second half. Championship week upon us, and when you head to Las Vegas to the Orleans Arena, the West Coast Conference Championship getting set to go Thursday night. Leading you all the way up to the quarterfinals on ESPNU, the semis on ESPN2 Saturday, the championship game on Monday, collision course between St. Mary's and Gonzaga, Matthew Dellavedova, Robert Sacre, two guys you might get a chance to see come Monday night from Las Vegas, the West Coast Conference Championship. There is Curtis Aiken, I mentioned him before the break. We're saying Len Berman and Bill Raftery on the call about 25, 26 years ago from the old Fitzgerald Fieldhouse. Curtis Aiken, the All-American, played at Pitt.
Was our referee tonight Tim Higgins working the game? He might have been.
He may have been. It was a great story. Louis Carnesecca was the coach, of course, for St. John's at the time. Harrison misses out of three. Carnesecca knocked over Bill Raftery's coat because he was so animated yelling at his team on the sideline. Bill Raftery said he came over during a media timeout and apologized. I told him at least it wasn't a beer. And that sounds like typical Raf.
That story reeks of authenticity.
Reeks of a certain smell, too, I imagine. Now you'll get a lot of Raf coming up this weekend from New York City. Big East Championship coming up. These two teams, at least one of them is going to be a double-digit seed no matter what. That'll be Pitt. They can get up to the 12. Meanwhile, St. John's, if they continue to do well, they could get up to the number 9 seed. Ashton Gibbs with his first two of the second half, and he's into double figures.
Guy has been quiet as the guy with the basketball right now. We thought he might be a key. Mo Harkless got injured slightly, left the game for a short while to get his ankle taped. Doesn't seem to be moving too badly right now, but boy, has he had a quiet night. Just one field goal attempt. He's 1-for-1, 2 rebounds. Those numbers are way below his averages of 16 and 8.5.
One of the top freshman scorers in the country. The other one is Harrison. He gets fouled. Well, the Big East tournament did start today. This is what it would look like. DePaul is the only team that's locked out of the bottom half into the number 16 seed. That number 8 seed is still up for grabs. The big one to get a bye into the second round. Seton Hall still battling for it. And St. John's would score off with Villanova, a team they lost to in overtime back in Madison Square Garden about a month and a half ago. Meanwhile, Pitt would square off with Rutgers. Rutgers beat Pitt earlier this year. Shot clock down to 10 for Green. He's been shooting well tonight. He'll take a tough three over Patterson and knock it down.
You know, we've spent so much time correctly to some degree talking about Harkless and Harrison, but how about Phil Green? I'm watching him on that play saying, is he one of the freshmen? No, we must have got the year wrong on that guy. What great composure, directing traffic, runs the clock, gets exactly the shot he wants.
Patterson missed it. The flush is there for Dante Taylor.
That was a statement finish.
Green for a chew back the other way.
So the NBA All-Star game broke out.
It's all of a sudden the fourth quarter in Orlando. Well, Dante Taylor having a big game tonight. 13 points to lead Pitt. Three in double figures for the Panthers. Here's J.J. Moore. He's been hot the last three games, and he buries a three. Jamie Dixon will call a timeout as Pitt is back up by 15.
Goodness, did we say at the top these teams were struggling offensively? My goodness, you wouldn't know it. Some spectacular plays. There's the dunk from the back. Another look. Good no call there. You're allowed the rebound from the back. There was no block out going on by Harrison. Then we had some offense going the other way. A dunk by the Johnnies, a three coming back by Moore, his first three of the game. St. John's cannot get back in it, giving up points at this pace. They don't score that way. They don't have any three-point shooters. I think Jamie Dixon probably want to talk to his team about, let's not get in a sense of false sense of security because we're scoring so easily. We've got to get back to what we do, which is defending.
The Big East Rookie of the Week, Mo Harkless. Big games against DePaul and Notre Dame, coming off 22 against the Irish, just 4 points tonight. Remember, he twisted his ankle a little bit around the 15-minute mark of the first half. He really hasn't been involved since then. Phil Green has had a big night tonight. A career high, tying his career high, 14 points, which he had earlier this year against Syracuse. But Green's been very solid, picking up the slack for Harkless.
You wonder if it's bothering him more than he's letting on, or because this is unusually quiet for him. They go to him now.
He and Achiuwa playing together, and Achiuwa will draw a foul. We get to Limsana for the foul. That's number three on the sophomore from Nigeria.
St. John's had trouble, a little bit of trouble getting it in bounds the last couple of possessions. You see how aggressive Pitt is here.
Harrison trying to get free. He is rejected by Zana. And Harkless gets fouled, and John Johnson can't believe it.
You know, that ankle's definitely bothering him. Right out of that contact, he's standing straight up a lot. Watch the block, and I don't know if we'll see it at the end of this, but after Harkless gets fouled, he just kind of hobbles away. Doesn't look like he's got a lot of bounce right now. Right there, he's wandering off to the corner. He's definitely hurting a little bit, no question.
Zotto will step off. They got Moore for the foul. And Malcolm Gilbert is into the ball game. Robinson knocked it off of Harkless.
That's what I said. They've been having trouble getting it in bounds. They haven't looked very smooth three of the last four times, and there was another turnover. I mean, that wasn't just close to a turnover. Pitt gets one, the deflection back off Harkless, who's throwing it in.
That team's at 10 turnovers tonight. Malcolm Gilbert, who did play 10 minutes against Louisville, he works down low for the Panthers. Here's J.J. Moore. Good ball. Draw the blocking foul. So Dominic Pointer stepped over to try to draw. That's foul number three. Two things that the Johnnies can't really afford is foul trouble and all these minutes in this tight rotation as well.
Yeah, but they're going to have to they've got to start playing. They just can't let Pitt keep steamrolling them offensively. Pitt shooting 66%.
22 of 33 for the floor tonight.
Not going to beat anybody giving up that kind of percentage.
I said some of the things that St. John's has done well as of late has been rebounding and defense during this three-game win streak that they're on right now. Meanwhile, Pitt, during this five-game losing streak, has cracked 55 points once. And they've got 60 tonight.
They're sell. That's already in the rearview mirror. But, yeah, you made that point. In the three wins for St. John's, last three wins, nobody has shot over 40%. They've been even on the backboards. The three losses before that, nobody shot less than 49%, and they got out-rebounded by 39. So they've gone back in time tonight for those games.
Try to explain the Big East to me. That's been the theme all season long. Gilbert on the hard hedge against Green. He careens into the lane.
It was a little too much for Green that time.
Johnson back to Gibbs. Gilbert the screen, Gibbs for three. Largest lead of the night. It's a 20-point game, and St. John's calls timeout. Jamie Dixon seeing what he hasn't seen in quite some time from Ashton Gibbs.
I really like his demeanor. You know what? What is that old saying about sports doesn't build character, it reveals it? You know, it's easy to be upbeat and animated when you're sailing and long and blowing everybody away and have the best winning percentage in the conference. This year, though, look at this guy's interaction with his team. Their effort reflects it. I said twice already in this broadcast that Louisville, they showed great heart on the road, tough place to play. Battled back twice in that game from significant deficits to get a chance to tie at the buzzer, and they're doing it again tonight in a last home game. Pretty impressive performance against St. John's.
99 career wins between Gibbs and Robinson in their careers, trying to become the eighth senior class in Pitt history to get to 100 wins. And this is their final game here at home, and I think Gibbs is playing like it. He had a tough senior night. They already had senior night on a weekend, their last home game against South Florida on a Sunday night, so the families of Gibbs and Robinson and the managers and the cheerleaders could make it to Pittsburgh. This is their final home game, and Gibbs has shown up big tonight. And what a hot start for Pitt here in the second half. What a night shooting. 68% for the Panthers.
And I was not a math major, but 9 for 10 in the second half, I think, is 90%, I'm fairly sure.
Need a calculator for that as well. Bob's iPhone has been in his hands tonight. Largest Pitt lead of the night. Bob, it's a 20-point lead. I don't know if you're a math major. That's a pretty good cushion for Pitt right now.
I was 10 when I started playing goalie, and I kind of got pushed in there. It was my turn in the rotation to play goalie, and I just kind of got stuck in there and fell in love with it from the first time I put on the path. I think hockey really brings people together. I think that's probably the best part, is just getting to know people and spending a lot of time with all your best friends.
If you like video games, you need to be a member of Gamefly.
Real gamers talk about why they love Gamefly.
You just go online, put games in your game queue.
They get mailed to your house.
You can play it as long as you want.
Ship it out and you get your next one.
Join Gamefly now with the special TV offer and get all the games you want delivered right to your home for one low monthly fee.
There's no due dates, no late fees.
With over 8,000 titles, Gamefly is the best way to rent video games.
First-person shooters, RPGs, multiplayer games.
This is the best way to play all the games you want for a great price.
Get started at Gamefly.com now. Save money and play your favorite games all year long.
Gamefly has a great value.
Want to own a game you're playing? Buy it from Gamefly at a discounted price.
I buy almost all my games from Gamefly now.
Nice thing is you don't even buy it for full price. Go to Gamefly.com now. Click the joystick in the top right corner. Enter college in the box and get started with a free extended trial. And remember, you can cancel at any time. Product shown rated E through M. Now you can also play PC games as often as you want with our new unlimited PC play, free for members.
And it's Schroff here in the Sports Interview studio. North Carolina's Kendall Marshall making history in the second half against Maryland. With this assist to Harrison Barnes, Marshall set the school's single-season record for assists, breaking Ed Cota's mark. Meanwhile, Cincinnati, a game that would boost their RPI, they're doing well over Marquette, up big. South Florida, one of the last four in, up one on Louisville.
Thank you very much, Anish. How about that? South Florida and Cincinnati looking for huge wins tonight. Seton Hall's got one more game as you look at the Big East standings. That number 8 spot, which does give you a bye into the second round, that is still up for grabs. Seton Hall and West Virginia both at 8 and 9. Connecticut is out of that race. They fell to Providence. They're 7 and 10. So West Virginia still on the bubble as well, perhaps. They're fighting for their NCAA tournament lives. Locked could happen, though, once tournament time rolls around, conference tournament time, and the Big East tournament just less than a week away. Here's Garrett. Off the mark, Robinson the rebound. Largest lead of the night at 20. Gibson Robinson have been big for the Pitt Panthers. We've had a ton of balance, three in double figures for Pittsburgh. Meanwhile, for St. John's, Harrison with a good first half has not scored here in the second, and Mo Harkless has had one of the quietest nights of his season.
Really, that was, we highlighted him at the top, and you can see what a difference, or I guess in this case, his absence is the difference, because they are fading fast here, and I think that ankle's bothering him more than we know.
Moore knocks down a three. Pittsburgh shooting nearly 70% from the floor tonight.
Johnnies have run into a Panther buzzsaw tonight, offensively of all things. They are lighting it up inside, outside. Great ball movement, not turning it over like they were in the first half, doing everything very, very effectively after the intermission.
Harrison with three on the clock, going to try to do it himself, and he gets his first two of the second half. 15 points tonight for D'Angelo Harrison.
Yeah, to that point about turnovers, nine in the first half for the Panthers, just one here in the second. That is a huge, huge storyline in this one.
And since about halfway through the first, the St. John's turnovers have started to mount up a little bit more.
Yes. Pittsburgh's taking their defense up a notch. And
Gibbs off the mark on the three. J.J. Moore rejected by Achiuwa into the hands of Robinson. Achiuwa there on defense. Garrett slapping at it. And Nasir Robinson will go to the free throw line.
Panthers flexing their muscles on the boards. That is the one stat they have been extraordinary at all year. Forget about second chance. Here's the second chance. That's knocked aside. Here's a third chance. That's knocked aside. And then a fourth chance. That's what they do. Plus 7.7 in the rebounding margin for Pitt on the year.
That's fifth in the country. They were second in the nation in margin a year ago.
That's why I said don't overread this disappointing season in the conference at 4-12. They're still at the core committed to the things they do, and they're not as far away as 4-12 might lead you to think.
Pittsburgh with a very impressive shooting night so far. 65% from the floor. They have their largest, or one of their largest leads of the night at 22 points. St. John's on a three-game win streak, coming off a win over Notre Dame. Pittsburgh looking for their first win since February the 5th against Villanova. They've lost five straight. There's two games in the regular season left before the Big East tournament begins next week in New York. And both these teams will try to go in with a head of steam. Likely both teams will be double-digit seeds. Pittsburgh will definitely be. They have a chance to get as high as the 12 seed. St. John's could be the 9 seed, but on their way to a loss tonight. Still 9.5 to go and plenty of time, but a big deficit, and St. John's will try to turn up the pressure.
Smart play by Moore. No reason there. Unless it was an easy layup.
Pitt with their biggest output offensively since that last win against Villanova when they scored 79. Beautiful ball movement and Taylor the finish.
Well, we saw it earlier from Patterson. That time Johnson with the drive and a nice bounce pass for the finish.
Under 9 to go. Oh, Harkless for St. John's with a season low right now, 4 points.
He's not even.
He's on the bench right now.
I mean, he was not. His presence wasn't even felt after the intermission.
Harrison draws a foul on J.J. Moore. The four guys in double figures for Pitt. Everybody gets involved.
Look at the good spacing. Look at that ball reversal. Everybody handles it. That's as good a percentage shot as you're going to get. Nice simple bounce pass. Good finish. He has been the beneficiary of a number of those tonight, Taylor.
15 points, tying a career high tonight. 7 of 7 from the floor. Meanwhile, Harrison leading the way for St. John's. He's got 16. Patterson in for J.J. Moore, who is into double figures for the fourth consecutive game off the bench. Pressure from St. John's. Pointer the knock away in the steal. Harrison will draw a foul. Shots coming as St. John's is in the bonus.
I mean, look, I don't want to overly romanticize it. I mean, you got two teams that are 10 and 22 combined in the conference. We talked about the effort of this Pitt team and how close they may really be, much closer than the record would indicate. And the same thing with St. John's. This young team has been very competitive of late. But, you know, as we said, the margin of error is so small when you just have one of those nights. That young man makes no presence. Harkless gets a little injured. And all of a sudden, you find yourself down 20. I mean, it's a very quick backslide in this conference. So again, as close as I make it sound like they are to going forward, small margin error to go backward. Pitt's doing that again.
What an athletic play by Robinson, but a steal. And Garrett, his own miss underneath. This is the effort, this is the hustle that you're talking about. It will stay with St. John's with 32
and that on the was, shot clock. And that was exactly the point I was trying to make. Strip all that aside, just look at the effort, the coaches, how the benches are into it. That's the thing you hang your hat on.
Don't forget, this is the youngest team in the country in St. John's. Pitt, obviously one of the toughest years, the toughest year under Jamie Dixon. You said it earlier, it's easy to just kind of give up. It's very easy to do that, but the effort and the hustle, and that's something that's been there all year for both of these teams, just sometimes the execution hasn't.
Nice tip.
Achua the two. Good second half for Achua. Yeah.
Been very active, very, very active on both backboards. And this press is bothering the Panthers, although that's a silly foul by Garrett.
A 16 foul against St. John's. Under 8 to go. 17-point lead. So when we come back, we're going to dive into the mind. I know it's a scary thought of Bob Valvano. And we're going to get his thoughts on Big East Player of the Year. Kevin Jones, I'm sure, will be in the discussion, leading the conference in scoring and rebounding. It should be fun. Should be scary. We'll have it when we come back.
Before you tackle your projects, stock up on Craftsman Innovations at the Tool Mega Sale this week, only at Sears. Get up to 50% off all Craftsman Mechanics tool sets and Craftsman tool storage. Plus, hundreds of other Craftsman tools are on sale. Craftsman, trust in your hands.
What? You got a dog?
Yeah, he's a rescue dog. Name's Wego. What
kind of name is that?
Call him.
Here we go.
Wow, wow, wow. No.
Yep.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Thank you. Here we go.
Here we go.
It's the sure sign of a good time. Just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
Anish Shroff in studio. Tony McRae in Nebraska getting ready for Iowa. Tip time coming your way at the top of the hour here on ESPNU.
Big one coming up for Iowa. They'll have Northwestern this weekend as well. Could be a huge one for Northwestern, too. 17-point Pitt lead. It's been as large as 23 here tonight on Wednesday Night Hoops from the Peterson Event Center. Bob Valvano has his opinions. You can hear it on the B Show on ESPN Radio as well. You owe me 20 for that, by the way.
That was very nice.
Big East Player of the Year. I know this has been a hotly contested argument. There's been a lot of, obviously, parity in the Big East this season, but kind of give me your 3-2-1.
Well, I start with, I don't think you should be punished for having a great team, and Syracuse gets punished, so I put Scoop Jardine in there, but you could fill in the blank with any Syracuse player. You can put Joseph in there, you can put Mello in there, you can put Waiters in there. I put Scoop in there. Hey, Adrian, are you listening back in the studio? That's for you. Adrian Branch is convinced he's the key guy, so I did that for him. The second guy is clearly, I think, the guy that's going to be the 1-1A when you look individually. What a job that Darius Johnson-Odom has done for that Marquette team. They've been pretty consistent. He's been pretty consistent and explosive. I've done three of their games. He's had a stretch in every one of those games, but he's just taken it over. So he certainly, if he gets it, I would have no objection. But the guy I put at number one is because I think without him, West Virginia's not even a bubble team. Sure. He is that much of a difference maker. They are very, very young, and Kevin Jones has been extraordinary, leading the conference in scoring and rebounding. And without him, I think he's the single guy that makes the biggest difference out of those three. They are not even in the discussion for an NCAA bid.
Just another young team in the Big East. You mentioned it. It's Jones and Bryant and a bunch of sophomores and freshmen.
A bunch of guys who can't shave yet. You're absolutely right.
I know the feeling. Good shooting night for Pittsburgh, one of the best of their season. Shot clock down to 8, Trey Woodall a 3. Something that Pitt has done very well has been crashing the glass. Garrett does come out with this one for St. John's.
Yeah, but there's Achua again, and you mentioned that. He's been the guy that's been active on both backboards. He tapped that one around, got his team the ball.
Pointer off the mark. St. John's not shooting badly either. I mean, when you're right around 50% for a ball game, you expect to be much further in it than they are today.
So one wonders how close it might have been if Harkless had been anywhere near his level. He has been injured for most of the night, tried to play on that sprained ankle, but basically completely ineffective.
Kind of came awkwardly down on it at the 15-minute mark in the first half, went out for a couple minutes, came back in, was limping around a little bit, never really felt like he was at his usual self. There is Harkless, one of the top scorers amongst freshmen in the nation, Big East Rookie of the Week. Man, what a dent he made as soon as he started Big East play. 32 in his Big East debut, a Big East record against Providence, at 30 at Cameron Indoor against Duke. The last two games has been fabulous, but tonight, just 4 points, 2 rebounds.
And it took one shot. He's taking one shot from the field. There was some discussion about whether, you know, the NBA people obviously very excited about him. Would he leave? My thought is, if he cares at all about my opinion, another year back would help him tremendously. But on top of that, from talking to people, and again, disrespect to Coach Dunlap or any of the staff right now, I think he'd like the opportunity to play for Steve Lavin for a year and get that opportunity. His track record of helping guys in individual growth is pretty good. So I think he's going to come back, but I think he should, to be honest with you.
Another turnover forced by St. John's. Garrett leaving it for Green, a new career high for Phil Green. And don't look now, but what was once a 23-point game has been cut down to 13 with 6:20 to go.
They just have labored for much of the night in taking care of the ball.
And a foul on Phil Green near midcourt. That will put Ashton Gibbs, one of the best free throw shooters in the Big East, at the foul line. But a big night for Phil Green, a career high for the freshman, 16 points.
And I like his feel for the game, though. When to go, you know, you don't want to put Gibbs on the line. You watch the versatility, the turnaround, the fadeaway jumper, going to the left. That one there pulls up and makes the jump shot. Gibbs is too good a foul shooter. You don't want to put him on the line. But that was the time to be aggressive. You sense the momentum had swung. You know, one steal right there, and all of a sudden it's down to 11 points. You got a chance. That was the right time to roll the dice a little bit. Green senses that very well.
Now, if you're a coach and you sense that momentum shifting, is it something that you see with all these freshmen being on the floor being too aggressive, or do you want them to come back and play D? Kind of what is your thought on that?
Well, I think that, as I said, that's part of the learning process, when to go, when not to go. Now they're going a little too fast for their own good, but I could see Coach Dunlap was pumping his fist like, yeah, they were of the same mind there. And that's what freshmen sometimes have the hardest thing adjusting to. And I think Phil Green's got a pretty good sense of that. I really do.
Gibbs, the pull-up. Final home game for Ashton Gibbs. 17 points on the night.
Nice little walk in the park there. That's the senior composure.
That's what we saw so much of a year ago. Guy shot nearly 50% from three-point range. Harrison, tough catch and shoot.
Lord,
D'Angelo Harrison. 21 for the freshman.
That was actually a little funny. When he caught it, I had no idea he was going to shoot it.
Achua will get called for the foul. That'll be his fourth, trying to be aggressive there.
I mean, really, he catches them. I don't think he's going to dribble it or do something. He's certainly not going to shoot it. Yes, he is.
It's nearly from the hash.
It's right in the middle of the. He made the bottom of the well, too.
This kid's got a stroke on him. I mean, it is fun to watch somebody like D'Angelo Harrison play. And it's going to be a lot of fun to watch a lot of these kids for St. John's play. Remember, this is the 10th game that the fresh five started. And Harkless is on the bench, but 5-4 with five freshmen starting is pretty impressive.
That's great.
So is that.
Well, that's his go-to move. He'll take your right, plant, come back and shoot left. Third time he's made that. He loves that. Actually, for a right-hander, he prefers shooting off that one bounce going back to his left at the end.
Well, this is some fight from St. John's, yeah.
That was dangerous.
Woodall to Robinson, knocked away, and it stays with Pitt. This is kind of what we saw from St. John's when they went to Duke, where they got down in the second half, but they made that comeback. Syracuse was a little too much for him, but this isn't the first time St. John's has shown the hustle and the defense late to get back into a game. But it's hard to get back in it when Ashton Gibbs is doing what he's doing tonight.
I was going to say, not the first time that guy's done that either. Nice game all around, good second half. Nice to see him go out in his last home game on a positive note.
Woodall with the reverse. Oh, my! Trey Woodall with a chance at a three-point play, and in pretty fashion.
Take a look. He's got some help. I wasn't sure if he was going to take it under to bounce it back to Moore, but I think he had this move in mind the whole time. Get to the other side of the rim and finish. Woodall, who was in foul trouble in the first half, has seven in the second half, and he actually kind of was a catalyst to the second half run for the Panthers.
Championship week on the ESPN networks. To the Ohio Valley you'll go starting Thursday night. Friday night you'll see the semifinals on ESPNU. Saturday, the championship game on ESPN2 at 2 Eastern. Will Murray State continue their run and keep the OVC at a one-bid league? I'm sure there's a lot of Power Six teams, as Bob mentioned, cheering very heavily for Murray State this time of year. There'll be a lot of Murray State fans around the Big East and the Big Ten, the ACC, I'm sure, when the OVC finals come around. How about Ashton Gibbs? He had a very tough senior night. Their second-to-last home game against South Florida. Big night tonight, the final time of play at the Peak.
Well, it was obvious. Jamie Dixon, after the Louisville game, said publicly, and I'm sure told him privately, son, get out there and shoot the ball. Do what you do. He passed up some shots in that game, and out of the shoot tonight, he made his first three. He was much more aggressive, but with that, didn't really chase shots, though. He did a good job of being selective. Shooting percentage is very healthy tonight, 6-for-12. Really was much more on the attack.
It's a 23-point game. It got cut down to 13. Now it's back up to 17 for Pitt. 4 minutes to go. Here's Achua with a good move. Got to get the Achua double figures in the second half. He's got 14 of the game.
Yeah, he's been really active, and obviously with Harkless on the bench, I'm going to be much more active.
He's playing with four fouls right now as well. I think that gives you a little bit of sense to Harkless, too. Not coming in when the game got a little bit closer. You think that ankle is probably something they don't want to mess with right now.
He's clearly not comfortable, and it was wise to get him out of the game. Looks like scoreboard watching going on tonight. South Florida with a 4-point lead on Louisville late in that one.
Moore, bucket from three.
Really a 29% 3-point shooter. You know it tonight.
He's been hot as of late. There's Green. Just off the rim. Patterson with the little Euro step to the rim. Back to a 20-point game, and the fans here in Pittsburgh, the Oakland Zoo, I think this is how they wanted to go out. In a very tough year for Pitt. And in a year where the Peterson Event Center hasn't had the same type of home court advantage that it had been known for, this is the type of home court advantage that teams have been used to seeing when they come to the Peterson Event Center.
Well, an explosive offensive performance. A good finish on the break there. Get the left hand by Patterson. But they've just been really efficient all game long. 65% shooting. They're 50% behind the three-point line. And when they haven't turned the ball over, they've been fine. And, of course, you mentioned Gibbs. Solid game tonight. Over 50% from the field. 3-of-7 from behind the three-point line. A good, solid performance in the last home game for him.
Pittsburgh with 84 points.
I signed those.
You did, actually.
Did,
yeah. The back of those are signed by all the fans in the Oakland Zoo. And you can check out twitter.com to see a picture of Bob Valvano trying to defend Nasir Robinson's portrait. But most points for Pitt since January the 25th when they won 86-74 against Providence. They haven't had that type of output in a long time.
They did a good job of exploiting what St. John's has to do. They can't be very physical, so they got to stay out of foul trouble. Pitt did a really good job of attacking seams and getting good shots.
Harrison, another deep three. Rosano for the rebound. And that's been a knock at times this year on Pitt. They haven't been as tough as Jamie Dixon's teams of the past has been, but no problem with that tonight. Pittsburgh with a 20-point lead, 2:49 to go at the peak.
Emily's just starting out and on a budget, like a ramen noodle every night budget. She thought Allstate car insurance was out of her reach until she heard about the value plan. Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you like Allstate.
This is the computer ICU. It's what happens to your computer when it gets infected, slows down, and crashes. And if you don't do something, your computer could wind up here in the computer graveyard. But it could be saved with mycleanpc.com.
Is your computer running slow? Are you frustrated with error messages, blue screens, computer freezes, and crashes? Then go to mycleanpc.com for your free diagnosis today. Then just activate the mycleanpc.com software to fix it in minutes. And computer specialists are available while you're online.
The best thing about mycleanpc.com was it had a free diagnosis.
My computer is 100% faster.
You know immediately what the problem is, and the problem is solved right then and there.
Download your free diagnosis today at mycleanpc.com.
Anish Shroff in studio. Coming up next, you'll get to see one of the hottest shooters in the nation. Matt Gaetans, in his last five games, has hit 27 threes, better than 70% from downtown. On the hardwood tonight, South Florida, one of Joe Lenardi's last four in, trying to get a huge road win against Louisville. Juwan Zapola knocking down the three, and it's the Bulls up three late. Adam.
That's a big one, Anish. Could be the one that cements South Florida into the NCAA tournament. They also have to play West Virginia. Not a top 50 win, but it would be a top 100 win and a good one at that.
Yeah, it's one of those. I understand. I've gone through it every year. The instruction, the committee looks at the whole body work, not Absolutely. Just in the conference. So conference games are just like all the other games. But come on, I find it hard to believe. You know, if they can win 11 games, 12 games in the Big East, that it would even be in the discussion. I mean, it's just, I understand. You know, it's not about true double around robin. Some teams get easier conference schedules than others. But look at that resume. What works against them is that one win only against the RPI top 50. They've got some losses against teams that are not having great years. But I'm sorry. And when you look at some of the teams that are in the discussion at the end, that team's got to be in. That's a no-brainer. It really is.
Philip Zana at the line. 85 points for Pitt in their final home game. Here at the Peterson Event Center, where they've won about 90% of their games since this place opened up. And this is a Big East season high, tying the Big East season high for Pitt this year. 86 points, which they put up against Providence. They do it tonight against St. John's.
Well, and a pretty good response when St. John's got a little sniff there. They got within 11 and looked like it was getting a little shaky. Pitt did a really good job of getting back on track and taking control.
Big night for Todd's gift to chew on. He'll go to the free throw line. 12 in the second half alone, 16 points. One of the better offensive games that Chua's had in quite some time, with Mo Harkless on the bench, kind of nursing that what seemingly is a bum ankle on a season low 4 points. God's gift to Chua, the junior from Nigeria. There is Harkless sitting at the bench. Junior college All-American, born in Port Harcourt, the River States of Nigeria, son of a minister. You see the names of his entire family. Soccer player by hobby in Nigeria. Found his way to Erie Community College in New York and landed himself at St. John's. His first year of the junior college transfer, part of the youngest team in the NCAA this year.
Let's go!
Lob over the top. And Dante Taylor, 8 for 8, 17 points for Dante Taylor tonight. 7 rebounds to go along with it. Garrett off the mark. Again, Big East season high tonight, 88 points for Pitt. Their largest output was 97. That was in a non-conference game earlier this year.
And our personal promotion, if they get 90, you buy me tacos.
That's right. Jimmy Dixon's going to call the timeout. He's going to get Nick Rivers into the ballgame. Senior from Phoenix playing in his fifth game. Always a good opportunity in the final home game that Nick Rivers will play as well.
Well, a happy ending to a disappointing year, although, you know, postseason is always a second season, as cliched as it is.
And we talked about Connecticut. I don't know, 5-5 is always a tough thing to do, but at least something Connecticut did to teams later on has given them hope that it is not out of the question to win 5-5 in New York City.
I mean, they have defined why coaches tell teams, you know, you never know in the postseason. Just keep digging, keep playing. That Connecticut team will be talked about for generations as the walking proof.
Nasir Robinson, 8 points, 4 rebounds, perfect from the floor tonight. He's on to the bench. Got a nice ovation. There's Rivers. Gibbs is still on the floor. I'm sure he'll get an ovation when he does come off. Still 4 on the shot clock here.
I think they're trying to get Rivers a shot. I think that's what Jamie was trying to do.
They're trying to do it.
Patterson threw to the other guy.
Rivers has scored just 3 points this year.
We're going to hoist one up now.
What a strong rebound from Patterson, but he lost it. St. John's has it, down by 21 with 1:21 to go. St. John's, one more game left. They'll play Rutgers at the rack coming up this weekend. Pittsburgh will have to play UConn. Pointer knocks it down for 2. And just trying to get ahead of steam going into the Big East tournament next week.
1 minute in the game.
Storyline is, will Rivers get a shot? Well, he was going to, but didn't see. It's like the block. Oh, almost a steal.
Let's see if Jamie Dixon will get Ashton Gibbs out of the game.
I imagine he'll start doing it individually, get guys an ovation. And here it is right now.
One of the great Pittsburgh Panthers to wear the uniform. All-time leader in three-point shooting at Pittsburgh. Will get his 100th career win tonight in his final home game, along with Nasir Robinson.
All right, one more try for Rivers here. Let's see.
Here it is.
Get in there. Maybe another try.
You want to see it.
Oh, he's going to go to the line.
I have a chance. This place is going to explode if Rivers hits a free throw here.
Plus, you owe me a taco.
And exactly.
Nick Rivers, 2 shots.
Calm as can be. That's a nice ending tonight. He made the hard one.
Yes, he did. River is still scrapping in his final seconds. Pittsburgh ball, 13.6 remaining. Robinson will come off the floor as well. Robinson and Ashton Gibbs will get their 100th career win. Pittsburgh with a Big East season high, 89 points. They snap their 5-game losing streak. St. John's 3-game win streak comes to an end. Pittsburgh will close out its home slate in something they're used to doing at the Peterson Event Center. That's win. Move to 16-14 and 5-12 in Big East play. The senior class, their 100th win, the eighth class in Big East history, or in Pittsburgh history, to pick up 100 career wins. Pittsburgh 89, St. John's 69. Coming up next, Iowa against Nebraska. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Bob Balvano and our entire ESPNU crew, Adam Amin saying goodnight from Pittsburgh, PA. Now we send it back to the studios with Adrian Branch. Here's Zadie Schwab.
All right, thank you, Adam. Bo Spencer in Nebraska getting ready to tip off against Iowa. That game coming up here on ESPNU in a little more than 6 minutes. Right now, we are going to take you live to Louisville, South Florida, one of Joe Lunardi's last four in. If they can hold on, this would be their best win of the season against a ranked Louisville team on the road. Five-point game. Let's listen in.
Chased down by the hand and big offensive rebound. Inside a minute. Keurig. Misfires. Collins. Smallest guy on the floor comes down with the rebound. So once again, Juwanza Poland is our Papa John's player of the game. Comes in averaging about 9 points. He's got 13. Nine of those 13 coming in the second half. 15 foul now on South Florida.
One thing you can't measure for Poland is how big those shots and when they came. They were all at times where Louisville's momentum was really starting to have an impact on South Florida. We thought the air was really starting to rise up and the fans were getting into it in this building, and Poland, he's been the ultimate shush guy tonight.
I'm sorry, Brooke, I said 15 foul, four. We're on South Florida, four South Florida, trying to get into that bonus. As Louisville's already in the double bonus with USF with 10 team fouls. So 51 points, it's the lowest total this season. That came against us, Syracuse. Syracuse only scored 56 against this USF team.
Well, if this holds true, that'll be the second game in a row for South Florida. They held Cincinnati to a season-low 45 points. And again, keep in mind, this is a team that leads the Big East, and they hold opponents to 57 points a game. You know, for a team as good defensively as they are and as many wins as they have, I feel awfully disrespected right now if I'm Stan Heath and not getting a lot of nods for this NCAA talk.
So Poland, 14 now, 76% shooter. When they were checking that time, too, the official said after the free throw, he meant after that two-pointer by Poland as the ball rolled out of bounds, so I should clarify that. But he inadvertently told us the clock was running after the free throw. Zheng clears, 47 seconds to go. They need six. There's that suffocating defense down on the baseline. Poland says they touched it last, but the official doesn't see it that way. So the Bulls trying to finish this game strong.
They've been on a 10-4 run since about that 8-minute mark. You know, but to me, it's been their defense that's been more impressive.
Keurig. That one goes. Well, like you said, he'll keep shooting them. He's got 14. His second three of the ball game. Five shy of cracking the top 10. He still has 39 seconds here tonight and a trip to Syracuse on Saturday. Of course, the NCAA tournament, Big East tournament, but right now it's the furthest thing from his mind.
We're going to get you right back out to Louisville in a moment, but Cincinnati needing a big win. They had an RPI of 76. No team with an RPI that high had ever made the dance. They score a double-digit win against seventh-ranked Marquette. Now back to Louisville, South Florida, and Louisville 39.4 seconds away from wrapping up.
That's the worst free throw shooter. Put him in the line, and you've got some good three-point shooters on this team, and all these guards, they are willing to take this shot. They've got the confidence to do it. You've got plenty of time to come back.
Well, Brooke, this just in, Cincinnati has beaten Marquette 72-61 in Cincinnati. So coming up Saturday on the Big East Network, Georgetown goes to Marquette. West Virginia heads down to Tampa to take on South Florida. Seton Hall DePaul, that's a 6 o'clock start, and then St. John's Rutgers. Good finish on the Big East Network. A Georgetown Marquette game should be a dandy for Milwaukee. Fitzpatrick.
We will update you on the conclusion of this game. Time to get you now to Iowa and Nebraska on ESPNU.
It's league night in the capital city of Nebraska. Tonight in Lincoln, Iowa Hawkeye Matt Gatens will continue his leap in the Iowa record books. It's also senior night here at the University of Nebraska's fifth-year senior, Tony McCray, and another fifth-year senior, Brandon Richardson, play their final home game. It's Wednesday night hoops on ESPNU. It's the Big Ten, Nebraska and Iowa.